Butler.
Please do not use
the flash. 5-1. May I see your racket, please? May I see your racket, please?
Oh, what a start despite that error. This has been from Kanat Jar. 8 of the first 9 points, but of course now he's lost recently thanks to this foul on the service, and he's lost another point there. Really gone on top of bowl from the off.
One of the reasons Jar's had...
drops out. Misjudgment from bowl this time.
4-9.
That ball hit the white line corner. Both thought it missed.
Shake of the head from the German.
4.
So rare I ever see Bull shake his head like this. We've seen it several times this game. He's clearly disgusted with the start.
6 game points. Yeah, I think he's just going to have to draw a line under that German.
Jato serve.
Luffel.
Let's see how Bol responds. He was clearly out of rhythm, totally out of sync that first game.
The German. You do wonder actually whether it was the delay that you were talking about earlier for the spectators to come in, which threw him out of his rhythm, because Jarre absolutely ambushed him from the first point. Coming off the back of that, took the first 5 points. This is better from Bol. Of course, has as much experience, more experience than anyone out there.
Well, Bol is one of the best in the game at keeping his unforced errors to a minimum. But that first game, we saw him make more that game than sometimes he makes in a match.
Great luck.
Response by Bol after that disastrous start to this match, coming out this game, starting out 4-0, but putting the ball on the table early in the point, eliminating the unforced errors, not giving Jarre free points like he did that first game.
Get on top of the German gradually is that point more wrong, Jarre.
Watch the backhand of Jarre. He's so good from that side of the table. You'll see any athlete that plays him, they're always trying to work his middle and wide forehand. That time, Bol not able to get away from the backhand of Canuck Jarre. That time you saw Bol receive to the middle of Jarre, and he tried to open up to the forehand of Jarre. That's generally the strategy you're going to see out there anytime someone's playing Canuck Jarre. There. We had a great look at how fast he is if you play into his backhand. His racket speed is up there with the best of them.
Yeah, it's been fascinating really with Bol to see him over the last few years. He's talked about it quite a bit about how he's had to change his game. You look at him now, watch video of him from earlier in his career, very different player. We've seen these last few years. Get a little bit more on from that, Jimmy, as this goes on. But Bol talks about that in his 20s, to his late 20s. He said, you know, I was as fit as anyone out there at that point. Obviously now, 40 years of age, the last few years, you have the younger athletes, the likes of a Canuck Jarre. He had to change his game to be competitive, stay competitive against them.
So 7-3.
Bol has done an excellent job this game of eliminating the unforced errors early in the point. We haven't seen him really miss any receives or first openings. He's smothering Jarre with consistency right now.
Seven, four.
The big change has been, I mean, you've watched him over the years, seen him for so long, 20-year career. Those changes that he's talked about, that he's made to still be so competitive at the top level.
He used to go back from the table a lot more, but as he's gotten older, he stays closer to the table. He said that players have become too powerful and too fast, so he's not able to go back from the table anymore like he used to. Oh.
stop. 4-9.
Again, it's so interesting. I rarely see negative body language from Bol. I've seen a lot of negative body language from him this match so far. Even this game, he's up 9-5, showing a lot of frustration out there. At this.
10-5.
Of course, when he wins the point, he's pretty positive. I'm talking about when he loses the point out there. I haven't seen him show his emotions like this in such a negative manner before.
Yeah. 11, he pumps up there to take that first game point. Bol levels up with Ja, 1-1.
I think that's why we're seeing such emotion out of him, positive and negative.
Right, Jimmy, don't get this normally from him, but because the draw's opened up, it's because he's 40 years of age. He knows that realistically, when we roll round to the next World Championships, well, he keeps on going, but you can't just presume he's even going to make it to another Worlds now at this point. However evergreen he is, however fit he keeps himself. So he sees this as the last chance. I think, as you say, that's influencing how he's emotionally approaching this match.
3-1.
So into the first towel break, Bol leading by a couple here, just trying to carry on where he left off from the second game.
Bol has to feel good about himself right now, able to come out this game still playing error-free table tennis. It's important that he limits the unforced errors, make Canuck job, make quality shots through you. And that's exactly what Bol doesn't want to do right there, Guy. He doesn't want to miss receives. He doesn't want to miss first openings. You want to make Canuck Ja work for every point. Don't give him anything for free. Well, two things about that point right there. Great deep serve from Canuck Ja. The previous point, he also had a good deep serve. We see Ja do that more times than one. That's a shocking mistake for these great athletes. Ja is not super confident when balls are high like that to his forehand. And that was such a big point that Ja missed. Instead of going 4-4, not only does he go down 3-5, but you have to think it really affected him mentally, because the next point after that was a disaster for him.
It's actually as well, Jimmy, I think a good point you make. It's the other side of having this crowd in here as well, because their reaction to the error, as a human being, you would have heard that. And then that bleeds into the next point, as you're suggesting. This crowd can be a massive bonus for him if he uses them in the right way, if he plays to the level he needs, but it can go the other way as well. wrong with that from the American.
4-7.
Break they
seven,
go. Jar starting to come back into this third game.
Not very often at a World Championships you'll hear a crowd chanting USA, USA. One of those reasons is it's so rare to ever see an American go very far in a draw. There's a lot of ways to try to return a net. That was an interesting approach by Bull. He went for the sky lob.
Wasn't far away from pulling it off in the scheme of things.
Seven all.
Watch the backhand right there down the line and the emotion of Ja. And now the crowd getting into this match, guy.
And it's the other side. He's got to use that. He can, but you've got to give the crowd something to feed off. Ja's starting to do that again in this third game. Such a clever receive from Bol, though. The angle of the push.
Look for the deep serve of Ja. He's been doing it all tournament long.
Ja!
And I love that play by Ja right there. Watch the safe opening and then build the point up and go for power on the next shot. Beautifully placed. A smile from Bol. Bol just said, that's too good for me.
Play, please.
Mm. Oh, Bol was 7-3 ahead in this third game. He's falling victim here to a thrilling recovery effort from the American.
That reaction by Ja was absolutely brilliant. Bol put that ball right into his body and he was able to make a great defensive shot.
Okay, here we go now. Ja.
9-0.
They've had their tail break. The serves to come here at 9-each to try and move in front again. This is turning into a compelling quarterfinal already.
Watch this low risk, high percentage shot by Bol right there. Didn't put a lot of pace on it, but placed it perfectly.
Inch perfect. Gives the German a game point.
Bol has been anticipating these short serves of Ja, wondering if he's thinking about serving deep here. Great decision. Great execution. Kanak Ja of the USA needed this point. When you have opportunities with players better than you to win games, you've got to take advantage of them. This is such an important game right here for Ja.
bubbling up, this, isn't it? Ball had the horrid start. Then Jar went away in game two. And what we're starting to get now, and it's the beauty of the format, the best of seven is, taking a little while, but we're starting to get them going here at the same time, which is what they've all come to see. Second game point chance for Bol. Oh, snares it, Jar cracks.
Well, 10, game to Bol.
Ten and two, his record actually, his matches coming in, and anyone who knows anything about the German league, obviously Bol knows about it, is there are no easy wins there. So he got his form together before these World Championships, playing those matches. Splitting the first 4 points of this fourth game, these two.
Let. To all.
Receive, wasn't it, from Bol? The feeling on that, that very low pace on it.
Excellent receive, but a very poor serve by Ja. He came out the first game, had some good deep serves in. His short service game right now is very poor. That's just great table tennis from both athletes right there. Watch the reaction and the speed. The defensive jaw, the speed of Bol. One of Ja's strength is he has great receive of serve. And that's what we're talking about right there. Watch the receive of serve of Ja right to the middle of Bol, and then that great backhand from his backhand corner there. When he's standing in that backhand corner and you play it to his racket, not a good idea.
Well, the frustration audible from Ja there.
Well, Guy, the weakness of Ja's game is his service game. For being such a great player, he has very subpar serves. He's struggling right now.
Jota. 6-4.
Ja has had more success after that first game receiving serves than he's had when he's actually serving.
Clear here, Bol, and this has got a concern Jar and the home support, the considerable home support here with the German opening up a lead here in the fourth. To the second towel break and Bol with the lead of four. Fascinating that they're both trying to control their emotions, channel their energy in the right way. Such a big part of this matchup. Ja obviously so keen to impress at home, go further, but Bol, as we've mentioned already, has got his own ambitions. He knows the opportunity here that's dangling before him. It's amazing to think of someone who's got achieved so much in his career here, and you can tell that he's just battling his emotions, trying to channel it in the right way.
Imagine the opportunity he feels mentally looking at this match and the draw itself. Great job by Ja.
8-6.
Coming up with two good serves that time. That's a weak receive there by Bol. The last two services by Ja have met the challenge. That's got to help him out mentally.
Come on! 8-7.
Time out here. Gritting his teeth and digging in here, Bol, even if he is feeling that strain injury that we think he might have there. Three game points for the German.
Stop. Please do not use flash. There's a flash just in front. 7-10.
Toughed it out.
11-7.
Bol might not be feeling.
One.
Now just a little bit quiet at the moment, the home support, and that's because of this scoreline. Kanat Ja started so well, took the opening game at a canter in this quarterfinal. But since then, Timo Bol, the former world number one, has won the next three. Block there from Ja. What about that?
I don't think Bol liked it too much looking at his face, guy. Ja get an easy point off his serve. In fact, it's It's also rare that he gets an easy ball off his serve. People don't tend to pop him up too much either. That serve right there, Ja has had success recently. The short topspin serve, it forces Bol to have to flick it. Ja has been much better dealing with the flick than he's had dealing with those pushes of Bol.
1-4.
Ahead this time for Bol. His turn to have some service woes.
Definitely fighting some physical challenges right now.
And I mentioned he's never had particularly the German the best of luck in the singles in this particular event. You just go back to a couple of years ago in Budapest where the draw had opened up, similar sort of narrative to what you'd say this time in Houston. And then he got a fever and had to withdraw before the round of 16. So he will not be presuming anything yet here, even in this position. Trying to go for the downright audacious there.
Watch the body language of Bol right here. He doesn't even make much of an attempt to go to that shot, and then look at the head down there.
And Charles got to see that as well. He's got to be
3-5.
Witnessing that and feeling even here at 3-1 down, he's got a chance.
One thing Ja's gonna have to recognize in this moment is Bol probably feels more comfortable playing defense than offense. And you don't want to do that if you're Ja. His receive of serve is a strength. Bol right now showing some struggle in his body language. You've got to make him earn every point. You've got to hone in on the receives. Don't take a big risk if you don't have to. Get it on the table.
Opens up the table there and into Bol's forehand.
That was interesting choice of serve by Bol. He served topspin himself, which makes me wonder if he wants the flick to come out so he doesn't have to deal with those pushes. It's harder work to have to loop a push than it is a flick.
Please make sure that this is vertical enough. 5-all.
Same serve two times.
5-all.
Ja frustrated there. He said, I've done that serve two times. You didn't call it before. Why are you calling it now? Because what it did is it told Bol what he wanted to serve. Now he's probably got to change the serve.
Fabulous.
5-7.
Credit Ja for finding some serves that are now working. Short topspin serves he's having great success off of. Bol has to flick those. In that last point, he did a little bit of a push, but he can't really cut it very hard when the serve's topspin. When Ja serves deep, he tends to have a better rhythm off the serve.
Six, seven. Play, please. Play, please. Left, 6-7.
See if Ja can make a good receive here.
made the space there somehow. Ball so quick, struggling with this strain, but he didn't show it there.
Timo Boll, watch this forehand.
And it's right into the pocket from Jar, to be fair, and Boll still found the space.
With the answer. Watch this step around forehand. Ja says, Timo, I can do that also.
Everything out of himself there on that last drive, that forehand.
Play, please. The
defense of Kanat Ja right there, putting him in a position to win this game.
See Paul grimacing again. He put so much into the first forehand, he just couldn't recover. To say, Jimmy, the defense of Kanat Ja there, clever as well, the angle that he found, of course, in terms of the amount of space that Boll had to recover. Two game points for the American.
Nine.
If you job. Here's a look at this last point. Ja's got to recognize right now it's the short topspin serve he's had the most success after. Look for him to serve short topspin right now.
Yeah, oh, Boll grimaces again and Ja.
Side topspin on it right there, guys. So Ja coming out, recognizing he needs to serve a lot short topspin.
I think he just caught as well. Yeah, it might just be a little bit of blood there actually on the arm, forearm of Boll. He just caught, I think, the edge of the table there to try to make that receive. There it is, right on the edge. That's nasty.
Is your hand okay?
Isn't that fitting, guy? It just seems like in life sometimes when you got something hurting and then someone comes and puts salt in your wound.
Left two.
Great deep serve by Ja there.
What an effort.
One, two.
He's going through it all, Bol, but he was able to dictate play there beautifully.
Kanak, this is yellow card for time wasting.
Kanak Jar as well here.
This is yellow card for time wasting. You cannot power now.
He's getting a yellow card if time wasting.
Please continue.
Crowd don't like it.
Please continue. It's in general for time wasting. I called you a few times during the time. Please continue. 1-2. Okay, here you go.
Jar picks up the yellow card for time wasting.
Great serve, great follow, Kanak Jar.
Way through that time. Wow, this is a battle that he's going through here in this quarterfinal, Timo Boll. The toll being taken on his body here. And it's ongoing. He hasn't managed to find a way to finish this match off yet. Points like that are just bruising on him.
Three,
the angle that Jar is able to find there at the table.
Watch the step around by Jar, wide out to the Boll forehand.
I'm not sure Boll, even at full fitness, would have got to that one. It was such a good cut. There's Boll responding. He's such a good competitor. We've seen this 20-year career. How many times he's had to dig deep.
Boll playing lockdown table tennis right now. He's really focused on the serve, the receive, and the opening shot, making sure he doesn't miss those. Has not worked for Jar the whole match. He went with a no-spin serve. Boll has handled his no-spin and heavy-spin serves with ease. Jar literally needs to just go to only deep serves or short topspin serves the rest of this match. Great receive by Jar there. Jamming Boll, short to the middle, taking that receipt quick off the bounce. Gave Boll no time to work with there.
Six all.
Crucial at the Boll, able to push deep and win the trade. Here we are again. I mean, the theme throughout, Jimmy, you've been talking about the Kanak Jar service here. Back with it now, six each in the sixth. This is going with what you've been saying here.
Let's see if he serves short topspin in some way or comes out with a deep serve. Nothing else has worked.
Oh, Boll there. Tremendous resilience. shot tolerance there to withstand the attacks.
Bol having to rely on his defense more than normal right now because of the situation. Topspin serve.
Does the trick.
7-0.
Ja with some of the better receives in the world. Desperately needs him right now at this point of the match.
That one again.
Bol plays this ball safe with the spin. A low risk shot, able to win the point outright.
And again, Jimmy, it's the experience of this man, isn't it, coming through? He's got Yul Groskopf, of course, in his corner, but above all, it's who he is. His ability to problem solve. This is an incredibly tough situation. Emotionally driven and everything else, and having to dig into all those reserves of experience. 2 points from the win. And he's clutching his side there again. He's almost there. Somehow it seems Bol is finding a way here.
I really believe that Joff feels like he has to serve no spin or underspin just to show a change of pace periodically in the service game, but he's had no success with it. Only short topspin serves or deep serves have worked for him.
Three match points.
There's the topspin.
All over Timo Bol. The legend, what an effort, battling injury, but into the semi-finals all the same here in Houston.